Well, here's the final piece. We'll start off with adding the grannies to this piece. Well, up front, don't ask me why it's bubbling, because the owner of this cardigan wants to add up one more. So I needed to add up some rows to make sure that my 20 stitch count is correct. She wants 8 grannies, so what will I do? I will put one granny at the first point and a second there. But I counted 20 stitches here. I marked my piece. 20 stitches there. And next marker. Put one there. Like this. If you just want to add the amount of grannies when you have 5 at the top, you have eventually 7 at the bottom. Then you count from here 10 stitches. Put the granny. Put a stitch marker there, and there will come your granny. And then 20 stitches, there will be coming the next, etc. etc. So if you want to add up one more, you can do it also when your front is open too wide. Please do the same as well. So then one piece will become here and the next there, and so forth and so forth. And at the other side, at this left side, or at the right front part, you will put one granny at the point as well. We don't fill this corner up. We only fill between the two grannies up, like this. Only this one. What will happen when we make the border? We're joining them together during the rows. So, attach them like this, or like that. How many grannies you prefer. And then we'll get started with making the filling ups and attach it to the work. To attach all the grannies together, we have already done that. So that should be part a week 2 or part 2 on the first 2-3 rows. You single crochet them together, and then you will start with the double crochets as long as you want them. I will advise you to put first a row of 4. 4 rows with the ripple underneath it from double crochets, and then attach your piece to your work. Why? That way you can decide how many more rows you want to add to your work. So let's get started with filling up these corners here. So we'll start off with the filling up like we have done on the bodies underneath the grannies downwards. So we'll start off with this way. So some people like it better, so I will explain it how to do. I already made 2 together to show you how it works. Well, hereby you should have been added your single crochet row and then your double crochet row. What we will do, we will take the wrong side facing. So turn over and here. We attach the yarn in the chain 1 space here. Attach it. Now we make 3 double crochets together. So first in the chain 1 space, second in the double crochet next to it, and in the third next to it, and pull through. That should be 3 double crochets together, like I've done here. Now chain 1, skip a stitch in the next chain 1, double crochet 1, chain 1, skip a stitch in the next double crochet, chain 1, skip a stitch, and the next, a double crochet. Well, you should have 4 in a row, so one more time, chain 1, skip a stitch, double crochet in the next. Now, skip a stitch, and then we're going to attach these 2 together, with 4 double crochets together. So, in we made a chain 1, so we skip 1 stitch, and this, and that one. So, the in the last 3, you take the first 2 stitches to make double crochet together. But we do not finish it. We leave the last double crochet unworked. Here we go to the next double granny. We skip the first double crochet and then the second. And in the third we make 2 unfinished double crochets. 5 loops on the hook and pull through. Chain 1, skip a stitch, double crochet in the next. Chain 1, skip a stitch, double crochet in the next. Chain 1, skip a stitch, double crochet in the next. That is 3. Chain 1, skip a stitch, double in the next. Chain 1 and 3 together. So 1, 2 and in the chain 1 space. That's number 1, number 2 and in the chain 1 space is number 3, and pull through. Chain 1 and turn. Now you have the good side facing, make 3 double crochets together. In the first, the chain 1 space, and on top of the double crochet, make 3 unfinished double crochets and pull through. Then 6 double crochets in the chain 1 and in the double crochet, you make each 1 double crochet. So number 2, number 3, 4, 5, and 6, and you will end up on top of a double crochet from the previous row. Then you take the chain 1 spaces, you make there 2 double crochets together. So in the first chain 1 space, you make unfinished double crochet, you skip the 4 double crochets together. There you make the next unfinished double crochet, 3 loops in the hook, and pull through. Then you'll be continuing 6 double crochets. 1 in the double crochet, the second in the chain 1. 3rd in the double, 4th in the chain 1. 5th in the double, 6th in the chain 1. And now we'll make 3 double crochets together. So 1 on top of the double crochet, 1 in the chain 1 space, and 1 in the last stitch from the 3 double crochets together. So that's my first unfinished, my second, and my third. And pull through. Chain 1 and turn, wrong side facing. Now, 3 double crochets together. 1, 2, and 3 unfinished double crochets and pull through. Then, 1, 2, and 3 double crochets down the row. Then you're in the valley. Here you have the 2 double crochets together. So we make 2 double crochets together. In the first, skip 1, and in the third, 3 loops on the hook, pull through, 3 double crochets uphill, 1, 2, and 3. Now 3 double crochets together. 1 unfinished double crochet, the second unfinished double crochet, and the third unfinished double crochet. 4 loops on the hook and pull through. Chain 1 and turn. Now the last row. 3 double crochets together. 1, 2, and 3 unfinished double crochets, 4 loops on the hook, pull through. 2 double crochets together, so the first, skip 1, in the third, unfinished, pull through, and then 3 double crochets together to end off this row. And then I will do it my way, lips away, 2 chains, cut the yarn, pull through, and move up the knots. And the second granny has been attached. Let's get started with attaching the bottom to the part of the body which you have already been finished. So what we'll do, we'll start off here to attach the yarn. I made my stitches here. Along the filling ups, I made 20 stitches between the 2 points from the grannies. 20, 20, 20, etc, etc. Now we are going to attach 2 pieces together. So, I will attach my yarn in the first stitch here. I will show you multiple ways. Half double crochet, single crochet, and the slip stitch method. So, first of all, you make your half double crochet in the first stitch. Pull up the loop. You take the part which you have must attach to the bodice. You put your hook from top through both stitch to the back, from the front to the back. Pick up a loop and pull the loop through. Now you will go to the next stitch and make a second half double crochet. Like this. Pull up a loop. Go to the next stitch, go from the front to the back underneath both loops. See here, both loops. Pick up the loop and pull through. One more time, wrap around into the next stitch. Make your half double crochet. Pull up your loop. Go to the next stitch, go from the front to the back underneath both loops. Pick up the loop and pull through. Well, another time, yarn around, make your half double crochet in the next stitch, pull up your loop, go into the next stitch from the front to the back, pick up your loop and pull through, and make your half double crochet, and so on and so on. That way you will be attaching by half double crochet. You can do the same with the double crochet. So you make first your double crochet, pull up the loop, put your hook through the stitch from the bottom, pull the loop through and make your next half double crochet and make your next double crochet. So now the single crochet method, it's actually the same. So you make your single crochet, pull up a loop, go from the front to the back through the first stitch and pull your loop through. Into the next stitch you make your single crochet, pull up the loop, go into the next underneath both loops and pull the yarn through. That's the same way as the half double crochet. You can do it double crochet, half double crochet, single crochet or treble crochet. You can do it all stitches. Then we have the slip stitch method. So what you will do is go into the, in the first stitch you will go through both loops, but first in the part which you must attach. So first stitch and into the next stitch, pull through and pull through. Show you one more time. So you attach your yarn in the first stitch, go to the piece which you have must attach, and then to the first stitch back again, pull through and pull through. Now we only take the back loops. So from the piece with the granny's hair you take only the back loop, and from the next stitch from the body she will take only the back loop. Pull the yarn around and pull through and pull through. Next stitch, back loops only. Here the back loop, so the next stitch, back loop, yarn around, pull through and pull through. Next stitch, back loop only. Here the back loop only. Pull through and pull through. I hope you can see it. Now you have a nice slip stitch row. When you use a totally different color than you have used here or here in the last row, you will see a nice V-shaped line between them. It's really, really nice method to close it up. Well, I use the half double crochet method for mine, so I will start with it again. So yarn around, make my half double crochet in the first stitch, pull up my loop, go into the first stitch from the granny's, and pull the yarn through. Next stitch, half double crochet, pull up a loop and pull through the loop, through the two loops from the granny part piece and up. Keep on continuing like this or every stitch you like, and then this part has been attached. So, I will do a couple of more to show you. Don't crochet it too tight when you pull the loop through, otherwise it will be shrinking. So, pull around. This is actually a sewing method by half double crocheting. It's a really nice way. So, I will finish this row. And I will give you a little bit heads up for the single crochet row and the ripple, etc., etc. So, good luck and see you next time. Well, as you have seen, I have attached the granny part with the filling ups to my bottom piece from the jacket itself, and I left this part as this piece of the granny aside of the edge of the front cardigan. From the cardigan. Why? Because I want to add up one more to fill up the extra opening on the front side. So that for you to show. If you don't have that, your granny will be attached here with the point, and then your will come out here on this line. So I have done this right now like this. We'll start with the ripple on the bottom. So we go to the chain one space and there we attach the yarn like this, and we make directly in a chain one space one single crochet. It is a repeat of part two of this boho Ibiza cardigan. Then you go with single crochets up the hill, so 1, 2, 3. And don't forget that your working chains on the right side, working stitch on the right side, because you're working on the good side facing you. So that is 3. What did I have said? 3, yes. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. 13, 14. Then I'm in a chain one space, so on top of the granny. Then I'm in a chain one space and make one single crochet. And then I'm gonna go with 14 single crochets down the row. So in the first stitch, I will make one single crochet, and so on. 13 single crochets more. 12, that's number 3. That's 4, 5, 6. 7, here's my 8th, 9 is here, 10, 11, 12, 13, and number 14. Now I'm at the chain one space, and here's my other chain one space. We do exactly the same as we have done in week 2 from the single crochet row. So we go into the first chain one space and into the second granny, the chain one space. Pull the yarn through and make your single crochet. Then move it up because your first stitch is here. Here you made your one single crochet to attach two pieces together, and here's your first single crochet from the 14 you need to make up the hill. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, and 14. Chain one space, you make one single crochet, and then again 14 down the row. Show you one more time included how to attach the two granny single crochet points together, and then I will finish off my row off camera, and then we will come back at the last granny. So I'm almost there. There. And that's the last one. Now again, the chain one space here, and here is my next chain one space. So put your hook through the first chain one space and into the second chain one space from the next granny, and pull through and make a chain one. So you will be repeating this. So you start with a chain one, attaching the yarn in the chain one space, plus one single crochet, then 14 single crochets up the row, one single crochet in the chain one space, 14 stitches down. Then you attach the two single crochet two chain one spaces together with the single crochet, and then 14 up, one in the chain one space, and again 14 down. And with one single crochet, you attach it two pieces together in the single crochet space. So repeat this throughout all the grannies, and we'll finish off together. Well, I'm almost finished. I already made my last single crochet in the last chain one space, and plus 8 single crochets. I need to have 14 in total, so 8, 9, 10, 11. 12, 13, and 14. And don't forget the single crochet in the chain one space, like that. Chain one, this is how it looks like right now. So don't worry that it's a bit curly, because in the next rows it will disappear. I make my chain one and turn. So turn the piece upside down, wrong size side facing. We start off with three double crochets together. So this first unfinished double crochet in the second unfinished double crochet, and in the third, four loops in the hook and pull through. Then two double crochets together, so one unfinished, second unfinished, three loops in the hook and pull through. Then we go up the hill with double crochets. So that's one double crochet, two, three, four, I need to pull my yarn, five, six, seven, eight, nine, and number 10. Here is my chain one in a single crochet one in a chain one space. You can see it here. It's this one. There I make a V-shaped stitch. So that's one double crochet, chain one, and one double crochet in that same space. So three double crochets together, two double crochets together, 10 double crochets up, and a V-shaped stitch in the chain in the single crochet from the previous row. Now we go 10 double crochets down the hill, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and number 10. And now we have to make 4 double crochets together with 5 skipped stitches between them. So you have done it already before, so I'll only show you how to do it one more time. In the first in the next stitch you make one unfinished double crochet in the stitch after. They would skip 5 single crochets, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and in the sixth and in the seventh you make each one unfinished double crochet, yeah, and pull through. 10 double crochets up the hill. I will go with you one more time. So it's 2, 3, let's speed it up a bit, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and number 10. Here's the single crochet in the chain one space. Again, you make there a V-shaped stitch. So double crochet, chain one, and a double crochet. This is how it looks like. So, 4 double crochets together. In between you skip 5 stitches. 10 double crochets up, V-shaped stitch in the top. This to be repeated over all points, and we'll finish off together. Well, I almost finished my row. I made my 10 double crochets down the row. I promise you to finish off together. So we started with on the right side here with 3 double crochets and 2 double crochets together. Well, we end up with 2 double crochets together and 3 double crochets together. So in the first and in the second you make each one unfinished double crochet like this, pull through, and then 3 double crochets together. Since you have made here in the chain one space your first single crochet, you should have 1, 2, 3 stitches left over. So it's the first unfinished, the second unfinished, and hereby the third unfinished double crochet. Some people did not came out with the 3 double crochets together. Why? Because they forgot the chain one, the single crochet in the chain one space in the beginning and in the end. So please don't forget that one. Got 4 loops in the hook and pull the yarn through, chain one, and you are finished with the second row underneath the grannies. So we start off with the third row. So we start off with the 3 double crochets together. If you're not sure if you have made an incorrect count, please do as follow. Here's your chain one space and count from the chain one space on 10 stitches back, so 10 double crochets from the previous row. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Then you know that when you're working on the incorrect side, this is the wrong side of your work, that your working chain is on the left side of your last stitch. Since you made three double crochets together, here is your first stitch to work in. Here the second and here the third. These three, you will make three double crochets together. So, let's get started. First unfinished double crochet, the second unfinished double crochet, and the third unfinished double crochet. Four loops in the hook, pull through. Then, 10 double crochets up the row. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. You make one V-shaped stitch in the chain one space from the previous row. So in the V-shaped stitch from the previous row, as you want, how does not matter how you want to say it, like this. 10 double crochets down the row. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Now you've got here the four double crochets together, the stitch before that and the stitch after you make a two double crochets together. So what you will do is in the next stitch make one unfinished double crochet, skip one stitch, and in the next stitch after you will make the second unfinished double crochet. Then you have three loops in the hook and pull through. That is a two double crochets together with a chain with a one skipped stitch in between. Then you go 10 double crochets up the row. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and number 10. Then I'm in a chain one space or the V-shaped stitch from the previous row. There I make my V-shaped stitch again. So one double crochet, chain one, and another double crochet. Well, this to be repeated throughout the whole row, and we'll finish off together, and then the rest is up to you, because you have already done that before in week two, in the first rows, to be repeated throughout the length that you would like it. And then we will start off with week six, the sleeves. So, good luck everybody, see you next time. Well, I almost finished. I made my 10 double crochets down the row, and I will finish off this row with 3 double crochets together. So the first unfinished, the second unfinished, and the third unfinished double crochet, and pull through, chain 1, and this row has been finished. Next row is, instead of 3 double crochets, you make 2 double crochets together, 10 up, V-shaped stitch, 10 down, 2 together with 1 skipped stitch, etc, etc, and you will end off with 2 double crochets together. To be repeated throughout the length that you wish. And then the last row must be with the main color, if you work with a main color throughout the work. If you work with multiple colors, you have one main color which comes more back into this garment than the other colors. Leave the last row, because the last row will be done in week 7 throughout, around the complete cardigan. So leave one row unfinished, so don't crochet the last row. Well, I will start off with week 6, the sleeves. You need 2 or 3 grannies, depends on the width of your arm, your upper arm. And yes, well, we start off with week 6 after this week, and I will say, see you next time. Bye-bye.